Hey guys, my name is James and welcome to another Eurovision reaction video with me. And today I am going to react to the British entry for the Eurovision Song Contest 2019 to be held this May in Tel Aviv, Israel. Today I am going to react, or rather review, to the song Bigger Than Us, which is going to be sung by Michael Rice, the winner of Eurovision You Decide, the British national selection for the song contest. The British entry, Bigger Than Us, has two notable names behind its songwriting team. John Lundvik, the Swedish representative for this year's contest, and the winner of Melody Festivalen of this year, and Laurel Barker, who is co-writer for several other entries that is taking part in Eurovision this year. Michael Rice is no stranger to talent competitions, as he has taken part in a few notable ones including The X Factor and Britain's Got Talent. He recently won the first season of All Together Now, which is now in the process of being sold as a global format. Most recently, it's going to be adapted in Russia with Sergei Lazarev as its host. Sergei is the Eurovision representative for Russia this year and also back in 2016. So this year, UDCI decided to have its format change a bit, with having two versions of three songs be sung by six artists, depending on their genre of choice, which matches their style, and yada yada yada. Bearing all complex explanation aside, I am a big fan of Bigger Than Us from the very beginning. I like the production value on both versions of the song. Now, as far as the interpretations of the different artists is concerned, I lean more towards Michael's version, as he's with his gospel R&B version, rather than his competitor, who went for the pop alternative genre type of song, type of interpretation. And one reason for that is, Michael Rice really has a really strong vocal power in him. Has really strong vocals, and I think he really made this song come alive on the stage. He really, it's like he has a lot of potential. There's a lot of untapped potential in him that needs to be honed for in time for the contest. And I think he'll be able to do that when it comes to that eventuality. Now, as for the performance in the national final, yeah, there's a lot of stuff that he didn't really need to do with like that and that and that and that. And he had this very unnecessary choreography going on around him. So I think it rather distracts me from fully enjoying him. So instead of just doing those unnecessary things, he probably needs to really immerse himself with the song, really feel the song, and own it, which he did, but he doesn't really need to do this stuff. Yeah. Yeah, I think the reason why, not everyone is completely happy with this is because it's a ballad. Well, it's not necessarily a ballad, it's an R&B song. So my only criticism of the song is that it tends to be repetitive as the song progresses, especially towards the end, where much of what you'll be hearing is the word bigger. Well, of course, it's the name of the song, but it really keeps on repeat for the remainder of the song. But again, I really got it over that, because I really do enjoy it. I really do enjoy Bigger Than Us. So that really speaks volumes of how you can really get past whatever shortcomings a song has if you really just let loosen yourself up and just enjoy it as it is. And yes, I have been in contact with the songwriter when the song first released. When Laura Barker, or one of the co-writers, responded to a comment that I posted on the BBC YouTube channel with regards to my first reaction to the song. It's just a minor inconvenience, but it's not something that's going to be the end of the world for me. So overall, I think a little cleaning up with the choreography and allow Michael's voice be the focus of the song throughout that 3-minute live performance in Tel Aviv, I think it's going to help the UK reach a very modest position. Is it going to give the United Kingdom its first win in more than 20 years? I don't think so. Maybe, we don't know. But I think it's going to be up there in the ranks of with the ranks of Never Give Up on You and Children of the Universe, because it's not a terrible song by any chance. It's far from it, but I think the UK really just needs to find a way to get the jury support that it needs and the televote support that it needs to gain a very respectable position, a very respectful finish in the scoreboard for future editions of the song contest. So guys, that has been my review / reaction of Bigger Than Us. I hope that you enjoyed it, even though I think that I may have messed something up while I'm speaking. I'm sorry. So guys, do you like it? Let me know down in the comments below. If you don't, that's okay. Let me know down in the comments below. Please like, share, and subscribe to the channel for more content. And I'll see you guys later. Bye.